Few men even consider the possibility of life on other planets. And yet, across the gulf of space, minds immeasurably superior to ours regarded this Earth with envious eyes.
Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new episode of Esoteric Disclosures, Ancient Alien Cities Uncovered in Antarctica. This is episode 3. Thank you so much for everyone who basically watched the actual first two episodes, as well as subscribe to the Esoteric Disclosure channel. Really appreciate it. So, it is quite a young channel. It is actually starting to now pick up and slowly take off. These kind of channels, which is basically dealing with, you know, the other side, which basically people tend to steer clear of, because one, they look at it and go, well, you know, that's a conspiracy theory. But it's not really conspiracy theory. I mean, this is actual, real, visual, physical, 100% proof. So look, you know, just because someone doesn't understand something and they look at it because they don't have that knowledge, or that they haven't opened, you know, their inner mind, their third eye, you know, whatever you want to call it, either their chakras, etc. People who can see can actually see. People who cannot see will not see, and they will totally deny it. And even if your friends are out there and they say, and you can see but they can't see, don't hold it against them, because you're an ancient soul who's been around for thousands of years. They're brand new to this kind of life. You know, they may have been one or two souls in. So the shorter the time that you're basically here on this, you know, beautiful Earth, if you've only been here for, say, you know, it could be 2 to 5 cycles, then the knowledge you're not going to know. But if you've been here for thousands of years and hundreds of thousands of years, etc., and you carry that knowledge when you pass, you don't go into the light, because everyone knows, well, not everyone, but I would say, I'll go back to that and say, well, not everyone knows to not pass. When you pass, you do not go into the light, because as soon as you go into the light, your mind is wiped, your memories, everything is gone, and the people, the master race that basically built and design the human population. So when you pass, you obviously, if you go into the light, then everything's wiped, you come back and you go again. So you're basically a slave to their system. And the reason why that you're a slave to their system is because they want you to live in fear. They want you to slave away, be everything that you cannot be, and therefore you will not learn. You cannot learn. And even if you thought you could learn, if a thing like that is basically just taken away. So, you know, it's true what they say. So if you hang around people that always work 9 to 5, have a beautiful house, have the white picket fence, you know, slave to the grind, yeah, sure, you can go out and enjoy yourselves. But as soon as you see anything in the sky or on land or etc. like that, and it takes your, you know, breath away, or takes your focus away, your friends are always going to stand there, it's bullshit, doesn't exist, nah, it's impossible. So then what you do is you basically fall into that trap and you go exactly the same thing, and you start convincing yourself, yeah, it doesn't exist. But then there's a 1%, not even a 1% people who basically, when they pass, they do not go into the light. They step aside from it, and guess what? That soul is allowed to choose the next life for their journey and keep reliving past lives, past experiences, past attributes. That if you're on a journey's goal, such as myself, you know, I've been around, my soul has been around for over 1 billion years. So I took a journey a long time ago, and part of this goal and destiny has led me to this point, but I will not reveal that in this video. I'll reveal it further down the track. So, you know, people who have an ability to understand the actual system in the actual esoteric world understands that we physically can actually visualize what we see on this planet, such as Antarctica. So in Antarctica at the moment, because of the thawing of the actual ice around the whole entire continent, we're able to basically see what we couldn't see, you know, 20 years ago, 10 years ago, 5 years ago, etc. Because, you know, Google Earth, etc., only gives you certain images and certain sceneries that you're allowed to basically utilize as, you know, searching and scrolling, etc. But, you know, Antarctica is ancient. It used to be a very thriving tropical metropolis that existed pre-human. So humans have been lying on this planet for 10 million years. But before that, there was no ice. It was all subtropical. It was a beautiful Mediterranean life, almost like, you know, constant, like Croatia or Mallorca, etc. You know, Palma, Ibiza, those type of places where it's just beautiful turquoise crystalline water. The sea almost looks like it's crystalline. The land, everything, you know, is just beautiful. So if you can imagine perfect palm trees, perfect sand, perfect buildings, you know, obviously completely different people 10 million years ago. They had different physiology, different way of life, different methods to eating, different, totally clean atmosphere, and a totally different sense of being, you know, not so much going out to work to the 9-to-5 grind. They had a totally different realm, totally different life. And then obviously, you know, our planet has been visited millions of times, millions and millions of times over, you know, a couple of billion years, could even be a trillion years. You know, the outside always refers to this planet as being their home as well as ours. So, you know, obviously they coexisted a long, long time ago. So in relation to all this, I have now just discovered another complete different section in Antarctica, which is absolutely insane. So, and also towards, you know, either the middle section of this documentary and towards the end, then I'll reveal, you know, what Linda Mouton Howe was talking about in last year's DVD when she released, you know, the huge black 8 octagon alien octagon, you know, how can I say, 8-sided. I've actually got the visual location of that, but as I was saying in the previous 1 and 2 videos, unfortunately I can't give you those locations. So I can visually show you from Google Earth on 3D mode what it is to look like from above. So that'll be revealed in this video, and then also revealed in this video as well. So we're going to slowly move away from, it's still going to be in Antarctica, but on the actual islands of Antarctica. So in the next couple of episodes, could be, you know, episode 5 or 6 down the track, etc., you're going to see actual 100% pure entrances to Agartha, entrances to Hollow Earth, Agarthan generals actually pointing the direction to Hollow Earth, 100% mermaids seen from Google Earth 2016. And I'll actually show you the actual attributes and physical attributes of how to actually spot them from that location. So I may give you the actual island itself, where it's located. Unfortunately, I cannot give you the latitude or longitude of this location itself. So if you're watching this video for the first time, hit the subscribe button and make sure you actually click the bell icon as well, so that way you also be notified as soon as a new release of the video comes out. And if you like the video, also press the like button as well. And also feel free to leave a comment, because I know many of you are more and very interested, which I totally understand, to actually watch the video, but to also just leave a comment as well. So just let me know what you think of the video, etc. So this one here, I came across this by fluke. Totally just random fluke, just, you know, not even searching, just for the sake of searching. I came across this insane region of gigantic ancient Atlantean cities. So as I was saying before, a long time ago, 10 million years before man walked this earth, Atlantis was never round, never had circles in the middle, and etc. It wasn't a 360 degree, you know, like it's been shown through Plato, etc. So Atlantis is a continent, very similar to Australia, but Atlantis, unfortunately, you know, took the short end of the straw, unfortunately, because when certain parts of the world, which I'll reveal down the track, when they became way too powerful and they discovered a particular, you know, substance, let's say that for now, the master race that basically developed that race before us, way before the you know, us in that class, every single race in every class, it's always around, it's always 10 million years before that and before that and before that. They always figure something out and get too powerful, and they can't handle it, so they wipe them out. And because of the wipeout, it's either floods, or the volcanic eruption, gigantic earthquakes, tsunamis, or an ice age. So this, 10 million years prior before that, unfortunately, was the ice age for this area. And this is basically what I have found. So if you come along, and if you have a look here, now this is very, very crazy to actually visualize. So you're going to see huge structure coming here. It's almost like this has been cut in half by 1, 2, 3 sections into the rock. So you can easily see that's a rock. And then you can go up and across and then down. And then the next section here, you can easily see that has complete form, almost like the Arc de Triomphe type thing. And then a huge plateau out to here. So it goes up, a bit of greenery here and then there. So that's been easily cut away. It looks like snow's come in and filled that area inside. So even if I zoom in, you can easily make it out. And then next to it, you've got looks like a black cargo type hold area. If you zoom in, you can easily see it's, you know, more black, except it's got a gigantic opening there and like something on the roof there. So I zoom out, easily see it much more clearly. And then down here, and just to you know, kind of restress on everything else. So if you look at all this, okay, you can clearly see it's greenery. You know, it's old, thawed out greenery. You know, old rock, old shrubs, etc. That thrives in this, you know, subcontinent of ice, but also thrives once it's completely thawed out. It'll basically come to life because the pollutants weren't that bad 10 million years ago for plant life to still thrive and survive after 10 million years is going to be insane. So when you look at this picture, then you can easily see a flat line. It's not a flat line, it's almost like a huge straight pipe. I dare say that's probably about, you know, 10 maybe 20 meters long. And then you can see an object here, building structure here, and then here it's easily spotted out. I mean, it's, you can easily see the building. You can see up here, it's almost like a gigantic sub factory of some kind, but it is ancient alien. and Atlantean mixed. But because this is, you know, Atlantean, alien would have had a hand in, and I'm not talking, you know, the alien stuff that you watch on TV. I'm not talking about greys or, you know, draconians, etc. I'm talking about real 100%, you know, could be blue avians. My guides are saying they had a reference in it, but also part of my race, which I'll lead up to it further down the track as well. So my, as you know, my soul name is Va'el, El for short. We're part of the El Esoteric. El itself, or Va'el, we come from a system that's over 1 billion years distance. And the race is called Golgarian. So in relation to the 10 million years prior, the races that occupied Atlantis were 20% Golgarian. The other 20% were Atlantean. There was a small portion of alien, and then the rest were either the blue avian, but then another race, which I can't reveal actually on video, so I've been advised not to, but I will sneak it somewhere down the track if I'm allowed to do that. So if you come up to this section here, I put UFO 58 because it's pretty insane. So here you can see UFO. So it's varying. So all this here is obviously rock, and you can easily see that's a rock. And then here, like some bit of red here. Just move this. And then here you can see a substructure. So you can see the line, you see a building there. It is very, very difficult to see, because you can understand something. On Google Earth 2016, yes, when you visualize cities, suburbs in national, say like places like New Zealand or America, places like Europe or anywhere else, anywhere that is constant, you know, foot life type thing, and constant people and tourists. So when you look at those images, you're going to get crystal clarity. But obviously, what they don't want you to see, or what they think that the average person is not going to stumble across, they'll still pixelate it out. So therefore, it's going to become insanely difficult to actually visualize anything that you really want to see. But because I've been doing this for quite a while, because my guides turn around and say to me, okay, this is 100% something here, so you need to look into it and research it. And obviously, you know, I looked into this area here, found this bit here, found that, and then I came across this amazing thing. So this UFO here belongs to this gigantic substructural technical city. And then when you zoom out slightly, you can see it a little bit more clearly. And then you come across to this. So this here, if I zoom right out, and then you can see, you know, obviously looks like the Arc de Triomphe. You can see a base there. And then I'll zoom in slightly, so you can easily see this is huge dome, almost like a, you know, a 360 mechanical watch. And then when you zoom in a little bit more, you can see it's got an opening. It's fenced here, or some sort of wall there. It's huge, so it goes up, across at a like a 180 degree view, and then straight down, and obviously there's something in there. So obviously that opens up, and then you can see something around there. And then here, I don't know if you can make the sound, I understand it is badly pixelated, but here, this to me looks like a gigantic mothership. And absolutely, you can see part of its weird fuselage wing comes down, around, cross, something in the middle, and up there and look, could also be an old Atlantean structure of some kind. But then here, if you go in here, you can easily see this. So almost to us looking at it, it looks like a mask of some kind. So this has pure form. So it goes up, cross, down, structural here, and obviously at top. But when you look at it from the outside, to us it looks like, you know, something that you would see in the Mandalorian or Darth Vader, etc. But you can easily make that out. It's definitely structural. Here you can either see an opening. You can see it almost goes along. It's almost like something from, you know, Agartha, where you got a huge walkway, or it could even be, you know, that's how they utilize their transport to get around. So it goes across, and then you can make out it's got, you know, a triangle is the roof, and then structure there, and obviously here, so you get an opening there, cross down, and obviously straight in. So all this area, it's almost like a miniature Disneyland. You can see something in there. So whatever this is, you know, it could be another Atlantean home, etc. So all this region is absolutely phenomenal to actually you know, discover it by pure accident. Hence why Antarctica is a really good place, because it is so vast, and so people look at it and go, oh yeah, it's just solid white, you know, snow, etc., and a couple of bits of mountain range. But if you really tend to actually visualize and look into it and move your actual, you know, northeast, southwest wheel around, go from 3D to 2D, so you can go up and back. So in 3D, you can sort of stop it to get to the actual desired effect. And then by doing that, you can actually see a little bit more of the actual landscape that you couldn't see before. So if I just try and change it back, visualize, go in again. So here you can see something, very ancient old ruin here. Definitely something there. So it's almost like a square or a hexagon. We can't see the other side of it. Very old, very ancient. Can you imagine this city, you know, actually having a time machine going back 10 million years ago to actually see this thriving? Be amazing. Be absolutely out of this world. You would think literally you were on another planet. You wouldn't think that you're actually on planet Earth. And Earth back then, to them, we call it planet Earth in this lifetime. Obviously, you know, we've been around for just over, you know, a couple of million years, but then everything has been planted here to make it look like we have been here. You know, we have religions, we have cultures, we have, you know, scientists and archaeologists saying, oh yeah, dinosaurs existed, you know, millions and millions of years ago, planted. We have, you know, people saying, oh, we came from Adam and Eve, planted, different religion, different cultures. They want you to span down that, you know, that arm side of things and spin off it and make you believe that, yeah, we came from Adam and Eve. Or there's other cultures and other beliefs and religions that basically is to tell you, oh, yeah, we came from ape, planted as well from the master race. So, you know, you can basically look at it and think to yourself, okay, so we've got all these different beliefs, but the one true belief that always basically is with you is your soul. Your soul will basically tell you exactly what is happening, what is going on, and how old you are to actually know within yourself that it's all a lie. So people who basically, when they die, when you go into the light, everything is wiped. You don't remember a single thing. But if you don't go into the light, then obviously you're going to remember everything, and you're going to be able to see stuff like this. There's a reason why your esoteric channeling through your soul is taking the veil away from your eyes. If you can see what is meant to be seen, then it's like when you stroll down the street, or before you go to sleep, or when you go out, or thinking to yourself, what would life be like 10 million years before life existed? It's a different train of thought. And instead of thinking about, you know, today's rubbish in today's society and all the crap that goes along and pulling you down, which is huge depression, think about different life, different variations, and how, you know, they obviously lived and survived back then. It's an exciting time. You know, it's amazing to actually see all this and visualize this. So what I'll do now is, before I move away and show you this awesome structure, which I also found as well, so you, this to me looks like an old ship that's crash landed, you know, obviously before 10 million years ago, probably even 12 million years ago, maybe even longer. So you can make out, it's almost like you can see the circle there, circle here, kind of something up here. It's a really ancient old ship that's slammed into the actual earth as it was going through, you know, tormented. It could have been soft rock, we just don't know, but it's embedded itself in the actual rock itself. And then here, very old ancient, you know, Atlantean substructure city. So you can make it out, it's dead line, circular, almost like a half horseshoe. So it goes up, and then you've got the triangle pyramid there, and you've got something along here. So you got to remember, back then they had totally different architectural designs, not like, you know, we see today, 100% different. And where did they get their technology from? Alien. Everyone gets their technology from alien. So easily see an arch there, an old city here, something here. You just have to look around. If you've got Google Earth Pro, unfortunately you won't be able to see this. I'm not dissing Google Earth, so if you know someone watching that actually works for Google, I'm not dissing Google Earth Pro at all. All I'm saying is they tend to cover up. So if you purchase Google Earth Pro, unfortunately you won't be able to see any of this, even if you go out there yourself and try and latitude and longitude and try and locate the actual coordinates by using land itself. So that's all I did when I watched Linda Mouton Howe. I actually used the actual aerial shot of where they thought it was, and it was near McMurdo Base, and, you know, through my guides, etc., I was able to locate the actual structure itself. So you can easily see something here and then here as well. Almost, it's weird, this one's quite strange, it's on a complete angle. And then if you remember, you know, because of the changes in the earth through earthquakes and you know, extreme ice falling on this, so ice itself, you know, a bag of ice that you would go down to, you know, your local how can I say, bottle shop, etc., and you've got a bag of ice, it's pretty heavy, and that's just a tiny bag of ice. So can you imagine the actual pressure itself, that if you had ice that was maybe 10 stories thick on top of structures, it's not going to look as impressive as what they should be, unless they are constructed from Valerian ore. And Valerian ore comes from a planet in the solar system of Golgarian solar system. It's a planet called Valeria, which is similar to a movie that they released, funny enough, years and years ago. But obviously that movie and the actual planet itself has nothing to do with each other. And the Valerian ore obviously is in a totally different language, which I will not speak on this episode or any other episode, it references under a completely different language, because 10 million, over a billion years ago, when Golgarian was thriving, we utilized a different language. So the language system is totally unrecognizable by any human form, unless obviously you're from there. So what I'll do is I'll keep going, and then etc. I'll go to another location and then show you guys that location as well. Okay guys, so still in the same area, just on a completely different landscape, but I dare say it's probably only, you know, about 5 nautical miles away from each other. I wouldn't even say 5, maybe possibly, you know, 4. But in this region itself, this is absolutely mind-blowing. So to work out, and I know you guys would be able to see this, so you can see almost like a gigantic pillar. You can see that has a straight angle, goes across, down, almost like a weird compressed hexagon, and then you can easily see the hole in the middle for, obviously, you know, craft to come out, or it could have been an old, you know, old huge palace, etc. And then here you can easily see, so the red on the top there almost looks exactly the same to the red there, and then here as well. So weird complex, but I dare say it's, you know, being crushed by the ice. Here's something that's basically survived. So you can have a look at this, and this looks like something that would come from a Star Wars movie. So you can easily see it's got a dome there, rounded section there, and then an elongated oblong type thing. And it could be, because we're viewing it from this height, looks like something you would enter there, there. And it's just their way of life, you know, their design. And then obviously you can see a huge entrance into this whole, you know, side of the mountain. So you can easily see something going into there and there. If you zoom in, yes, it's densely pixelated, but when you zoom out, you can easily make it out even more clearly. And then down here, so here you can make out only just, it is pixelated a fair bit, but here you can make out there was something here. So that's a huge either wall, or, you know, it looks like a something to do with a building, because you can see something here, domed there. You can almost see like a, it's almost like a mud hut or rock village, but it's probably not. It's probably, you know, incredible to actually look at if you were physically standing here. And then something down here, which is basically not yet thawed out from here, because you can easily see the ice still on top of it, but you can easily make out something. So that's, it's red of some kind, and then there, and it's good, it's got structural form to it, so it's gigantic, whatever it is. Here you can make out the black Valerian ore that's basically utilized to build this substructure, and you can see a gigantic opening going directly into the actual mountain itself. So it goes up, cross, down, and you can see obviously a bit of weeds and moss, etc., dangling from the ceiling. But this substructure here is made out of black Valerian ore, which is exactly the same substance that is basically utilized from the 8-octagon superstructure that actually represents about 8 football fields long in length, and is around about 8 to 10 stories deep, with each level having a totally different reference to a different race. So it survived over 80 million years. So Valerian ore is designed to be flexible and to last over a trillion years. Definitely something in here, either a really old platform. We can see it, it's almost a hexagon. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And because of all the rock, etc., and the moss and overhanging of the green, unfortunately you can't see that, but you can see something long and directly to go into there. So you just got to look around, guys. I mean it's insane. You can stop this and or pause this video, etc., and then take the time for yourself and physically look at the images, physically look at the mechanical side of things, and you can see. So obviously your ship will go directly into there, it'll probably come up, and you be basically, that's part of the actual substructural base, old Atlantean base. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. So pretty impressive, absolutely really, really impressive. You zoom out, you can clearly see it a little bit more clearly. You can see it there and straight in. All right, so what I'll do is I'll show you one other section before I get on to the 8 octagon region, and then this section here, look, is pretty insane, but I'd probably have to do this at night when it's actually sunny. It's nighttime outside, because it actually gives the visualization a much clearer picture on what you guys see. But hopefully the recording on this system will actually allow it to bring it up. So if you can imagine an anchor, and what the anchor actually looks like. So here, to me, this is a resemblance of this particular area. And this is their way of basically acknowledging, okay, you've come into this particular city. You know, that's their, how can I say, their logo type thing. So it's pretty interesting. It goes straight down under, almost like an anchor. You've got something in the middle, and you got something just here. But then if you come across, you can make this out. So this is hexagon shape as well. You get something in the side, and then it comes out. So this is really, really old, and I dare say this has been, you know, crushed by extreme pressure of landmass moving, and then obviously frozen snow and ice on top of it. So you can eat 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 easily. Something here, and if you go up, you can see something that's obviously built into the actual land itself, almost like something from Lord of the Rings, like Elvian nation. And then you got something here, which, you know, you can barely make it out. It's a platform. And obviously the snow, etc. If you come across to this section, I know this is going to be very difficult to see, because it is anything from the light to the dark is incredibly hard to see. But the more that you, if you pause this video and then just sit and wait till your eyes, you know, allow you to basically see this, you will be able to see mechanical structure here. A huge walkway, or an old ancient, you know, city that had huge footpaths, etc. And this is obviously no longer here. Huge along here, and then up here you've got some sort of wall. It's weird because it looks like it's crisscrossed. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then crisscrossed. Could be an old fence, and then huge opening right there, and then huge structure here, obviously like a slanted roof, and then got something up here. But if I zoom in, you can easily make it out a little bit better. Yes, it is pixelated. I get that. And then easily a structure and something along here as well, and then something up here. So I dare say, you know, because of the collapse of you know, upheaval, etc., obviously it's not left the way it would have been created originally. But yeah, still absolutely very impressive all along here. So you've got tunnels, so you got one there, so you can see the square that's built in. Very hard to see, very faint. And all along here as well, but very, very hard to see. So this is the only stuff that pretty much stands out that you can actually see it. So it's very interesting. Right, so with that, I will show you one other, because I thought when I saw this structure, I actually thought this was pretty insane. And then I'll basically move into the other one. So I'll just go and locate this now, and then I'll come back to you. All right, guys, back again. Okay, so this is probably, I dare say, a couple of miles again, away from the other site, but still in the same mountain range, just pretty much over the hill and a little bit further on, etc. So this one here, I put ship 58. So you can easily make it out. So that's, as I said, it's probably something that you would see from, you know, Star Wars, etc., or Star Trek. See, you can clearly make out it's got windows, it's got a roof, it's got something on top. And I dare say that's not wheels. I dare say that's propulsion system. So if I zoom out a little bit, you can easily see that. That should be a lot clearer. And then you zoom in slightly again to make it out. Yeah, it is, you know, obviously a vertical ship that can obviously land and use its propellers to twist and fall, etc. And then all along here, this is one of the most amazing complexes. So if you can make out this structure here, structures here, here, all the way along from here, so it's a flat plateau. Structure up there, you can see the dome, you can see it's kind of rounded. And then here, structure, huge structure here, so you can see a path coming along here, obviously it goes down. It's huge, almost looks like an old, you know, reference of a dying spider, but I dare say it's not. And something in there, it's weird structures, this one up here. So you can easily see structure, and then all the way along here. So this is the black Valerian ore, sticks out, structures there. Then obviously it comes down here, and you've got some sort of gigantic substructure city. So it's still basically thawing. You can see that's got shape. So one, two, so it's got shape and an angle. And this here, take reference of this, because that logo there shows up in a completely different area on the other side of the earth near Cheyenne Mountain. And please reference this, because that picture there shows up exactly where an entrance is into on the opposite side of Cheyenne Mountain, which I'll mostly show you guys towards the end of the series. So you can easily see something here, and easily see that has complex form. It's got windows or, you know, openings, etc. And then a really thriving, bustling once, you know, city. And then obviously craft here. So I dare say, you know, the people that obviously are paying for this black budget agenda site, not obviously not telling the government, and just carrying on beyond any means necessary to actually, you know, replicate, steal, pick everything dry, and either, you know, leave it as is, or take the technology for themselves, which, you know, basically exactly what mankind has basically been doing for generations on end. So it wouldn't surprise me in the slightest. Which is a real shame. They could obviously share and allow people to actually see this, but obviously they don't. So, you know, maybe one day we'll get to actually see this. Here is an enormous structure here. So obviously it goes directly into the rock, and you can see that's made out of Valerian ore as well. Not as dark as some of the other ones like this one, but still the same. Okay guys, so what I'll do is I'll go and locate the 8 octagon black Valerian ore structure that's over 80 million years, and I'll come back to you. Okay guys, so this is the last section of this video for part 3, and as I was saying previously in episodes 1 and 2, here is the actual octagon. I actually put hex structure just in case, because I got really excited and I thought, well, far out, you know, if I actually put say 8 octagon structure located, etc., I'm going to be in serious trouble. So my guides basically advised me not to worry, don't stress, because you'll never be found out. I wanted to reveal this to you. Bear in mind, this here and here and here are different. It's still made from the Valerian ore. It's still utilized from the same subparticle of the actual ore itself. But before I show you, have a look. So this, you can see a plateau up here. You can see this is structural. Huge structure of Valerian ore. Comes around, almost looks like, I know it's pixelated, but the more that they don't want you to see, the more pixelated the picture will become. And funny enough, you can still see it, and I'm glad I'm recording this to actually show you guys, to put up on YouTube, because I've got to say, this is phenomenal to actually visualize. So here you can make out some sort of, you know, weird, looks like a slant structure. You can see two pipes going up, and then here you've got an entrance. So you can clearly see there's an entrance there. It looks like it's sliced, and then a barrier to basically protect whatever's inside. Some sort of structure here and here. But then here, so here's the black octagon structure that they're talking about. Now, you can only see part of it. You cannot physically see the full version of this, because this is 2016. So if we're visualizing 2016, it's nearly 5 years ago. This is still in the ice itself. So you can easily see that's ice there. So if you look at it, it's 1, 2, and then 1, 2. So it'll be 4 so far. And then obviously that's half of it that's still in the ice. Huge black reference, huge Valerian ore superstructure right next to, you know, an old hill. And I can tell you, this is very, very close to McMurdo Base. That's all I can tell you. So feel free to, you know, surf around, but if you have Google Earth Pro 2020 and 21, you will not see this. You know, I spoke to Linda Mouton Howe probably about 2.5 months ago, when she released a video in relation to, you know, just reviewing what she talked about with Spartan 1 and Spartan 2 in relation to this 8 octagon superstructure. And I spoke to her over the phone and told her I had a location. I gave her the latitude and longitude, because she originally came up with this, so I thought obliged to actually give her the information. She had a look at it, and I can tell you now without a shadow of a doubt, and she had Google Earth Pro 2020, she could not see this. I gave her other locations for latitude and longitude, and she still couldn't see it. So if you have a paid thing, look, you can either stick with it or get another account and have basically Google Earth And they'll give you the old version of it. They won't give you the updated version, because updated version, obviously you can't see any of this structure. So what I was saying before with Linda Mouton Howe, so she is 100% correct in her findings with Spartan 1 and Spartan 2 in relation to the actual location. As I was saying, I can't stress it enough, Google Earth Pro, no offense to Google, but if you want to see this, do not go out and buy Google Earth Pro, because unfortunately you will not get to see this structure. And no offense to Google, you're not slandering the product in any way, but you're more than welcome to go out and get the standard, you know, Google Earth, etc. So just moving on from that section there, you can easily make this out. So this is almost structural in the actual whole system itself. So here you can see there's, you know, it comes down there, etc. And that's got form. It's got a roof, a structure here. It's got wall. It's almost like a plateau there, and then some sort of joining up here, and then here and here. So this whole region is structural. And when you zoom out, you can see it a little bit more clearer, I should say. And up here, you could see something easily there, and then here as well. And all along here, so here you got 1, 2, 3, almost looks like a gigantic holding pen for something to us. That's maybe what it looks like, but I dare say it's not. And that's a huge opening in there for some sort of opening. Dare say that opens and something comes out. But that's an amazing city. In fact, if I try and turn this a little bit. So now that's a little bit more clearer. Yes, it is pixelated. But as I was saying before, the more pixelated stuff, the more they don't want you to see what is actually in plain sight. So you can easily make this out now. So that has, so that's huge city structure there. Something on the ground. I dare say that's, you know, like could be a security base. And then structure here comes all the way along down. So different color. So again, that's lightish brown. That's dark Valerian ore. Along here and then along here, and it becomes whitewashed in the actual city. And you know, just referencing it, I know it doesn't look like it, but it looks like something from New York as you're looking down on the city itself. I mean, it's just fantastic. So you've got one city here with Hyde Park, etc., and then you come across to another section of the city on the opposite side of the lake, if that was a lake. And then obviously something up here, and you can easily see structures up here. It's black and white, definitely Valerian ore structure. This is all made with Valerian ore. All this here, Valerian ore structure here. It's an off shaded Valerian ore, not as robust as the original black, but still pretty strong. And then obviously something here, and then you can obviously, now that it's the computers, Google Earth is more complacent, because if you leave the image in that section for quite some time, it does, however, allow you to see a little bit more clearer. And it looks like a tunnel, so you would go up there with your car, etc., and go all the way along. And I dare say there are pillars underneath and some sort of structure. And going back to this, so here it looks like some sort of weird, to us it looks like a human form, you know, laying in the snow. But this is gigantic. So if you look at this, this is 8 football fields long, etc. And then 8 to 10 stories deep, with each level representing a 10 million year old human existence. So the races that seeded us, because we are not the first race, all reside in this ancient master race built substructure and houses all the original chromosomes from all 80 million years ago. seeds. But it also is fascinating itself because it gives you true destination of where we come from. So you can see this as well. It's almost like a huge fan on top, and then the structure there. And then obviously this blue here is only a reference to the snow. That's basically melted, and you know, you've got some water in there, etc. And then along here, so you can barely make that out, so it's a structure just in there. And then huge structure here, so it goes along, it stops in there, it's got like a tiny gap, and then comes along here. Huge structure, and here as well. Something here, gigantic white wall, and then something on top of it, which you can hit, window, door, another door, you can see the arch, and then comes along the actual end of it. All right, so thanks so much for tuning in. All right, just before I go, this is the substructure I referenced before. As you zoom into it, now it's starting to make sense a little bit more better. So it's not the same structure that we saw in episode one, because you can easily see a circle and then a huge circle, another circle here, and some sort of structure here. But this is amazing. This is a mega complex. I dare say it is ancient Atlantean mixed with alien tech. That is absolutely incredible. You can easily see that's a roof and then some sort of structure down there for entrance. You zoom out, you can make it out more easy. Totally different from everything else because it is, you know, rock. But you can easily make out the difference between a rock and a structure like this. Very impressive. Right, guys, so yes, there is something here. I can basically search for hours and hours and hours, but I don't want to keep going because I basically ruin it for further issues down the track. But one other structure before I go is this one here. So that's Valerian Ore, and that to me looks like a gigantic tunnel system that's outstretched in the actual region itself. So it's all mechanical here, a mechanical here, and then a black dome there, which looks really impressive. And then some sort of city here. You can see the lines. So it goes here, down, up, down, down there, cross, cross here, and then it stops. But it's in the side of the actual wall itself. Looks pretty impressive. So without further ado, thanks so much for tuning in. My name is El. Thank you very much for watching Esoteric Disclosure. Thank you also for being a part of the mini-series, which is a 15-part mini-series of ancient alien and Atlantean cities uncovered in Antarctica. That will obviously change to ancient alien and Lumerian, and also ancient alien and Agarthan, and then ancient alien and Akkadian. So all this is still referenced to the same visualization that I'm showing you. The only difference is as we move out of Antarctica, it is going to be a lot more clearer in what you see for further down the track. It won't be as pixelated as what you're visualizing here. So thank you again, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. We all are also releasing down the track as well another amazing interview that Jay has also done with a gentleman named Ben. So he's gonna he's already done that live one-on-one interview with Jay, so I'll edit that out in the next month or so. And then more interviews obviously done with Tony Rodriguez, and then Remy Starr as well, and maybe a few other gems that I'm not going to just release to just yet, but they're basically in the pipeline. So tune in for episode 4 And episode 4 will basically be more referencing of similar structures to this, but other structures plus I'll reference, I'll show you a very snippet peek into the Agarthan General's location to Hollow Earth. So stick around for that one, because I can tell you now the actual Agarthan General pointing to the location to Hollow Earth is pretty fantastic. All right, guys, thanks so much for tuning in, and I'll catch you later.